On today's video, I will show you how to use Figma for web design and how to streamline your web design process for efficiency so that you can deliver great websites fast and easy. So check this out. Here is the website before and after, and seemingly there's not a big difference, but the devil is in the details, right? We have those illustrations, we have a more structured content and overall better design. So this is the old design that actually I did it as well back in 2021 using Adobe XD, but my client came back to me with a request to update, and now I redesigned this using Figma. We're gonna talk about things like building the wireframes, writing the copy, adding the content, creating a style guide, and then designing the homepage. But before we do that, let's actually dive in into Figma. Here is my wireframe with some dummy content, right, and some placeholders, and here is the actual content, the actual headlines and the paragraphs, and then here is the actual design, right? So how I went from this to this to this. Okay, so first I had a phone call with my client. My client said that they've been working with this guy, but he struggled with the UI, right? So he could not bring consistency to the design. So I took some notes during the call. Here are some of the notes. Well, basically, we're just gonna improve the layout. We're gonna... and things like that. Let's start with Figma. So Figma is a free software. Sign up for free on figma.com. Once you are in, it's just gonna look like this. Let me create a new file. When you look at this design, we could just start designing this from scratch. So what we need is like a green rectangle, right? We need to bring our logo in, set the menu, create the buttons, bring in this illustration and those logos and so on, and organize this on the page, create like a layout, right? Here is a quick introduction to Figma interface. So for example, you could start with creating a frame. That's where you always start. You can set this frame for 1440 and then you can make it as long as you want. So basically this is how it works. This is a canvas. These are the layers. If you create something, is gonna show up here. Like let's say I add this rectangle, right, and I can change the color of this rectangle to some random green, right, and I can start building the website this way, right? I can start building the header just like that, then grab the text. So it's very intuitive. You just drag this like that. I can just copy this from here. If I paste it unformatted, it's gonna look like this. You can change the font here. We're using the styles here, which I'm gonna explain in a second, but the font is LoRa. So you could do it this way. Just select the font, select the size, like 60, let's say, change the color. So these are the properties panel on the right, right? All the properties, padding, margin, alignment, text size, color, and so on, and other effects, right? And so we could start building the website this way. But I'm gonna show you a better way to build websites. Now I'm gonna show you how to actually do it the right way. So we're gonna start with building wireframes. So what I like to do is I like to use Reloom library, because they provide free Figma files, so it's all for free. You can just go there, find the link in the description. You can just open this in Figma. Once you open this, it's just gonna look like this. You're just gonna have these all these components here. So you're gonna have multiple option layouts for your navbar, right? The logo could be aligned on the, be on the left, the menu could be on the right, the menu could be centered, the logo could be centered, and so on. You could have like a very complex menu and stuff like that. Different options, the same with the footers, right? You can have a subscription box here on the left, on the right, social media icons, keep it very simple. The same with headers, right? So as you notice, probably I'm using something like the images on the right and we have the text on the left, right? The beauty of using this as a starting point is that you have all those common sections like headers, featured sections, even like specific pages like career sections, gallery for images if you want to build like a portfolio, right? Or show the team members, right? The contact forms, like different options, right? So you don't have to build this from scratch, because it's gonna be very mundane, like having to build each component. So what I like to do, I like to have a phone call with my client, right? Go through their requirements, go through our website and try to establish what kind of sections do we need. So we need a hero section, right? Maybe we need to talk about the benefits of buying these courses. Maybe we need to talk about the company a little bit and then show the products, right? And stuff like that. So what I did basically is, instead of like building this from scratch, let's actually close this, open this Figma file from Reloom, find the right sections, So let's say we need a hero header. So what I did is I just basically selected, okay, we decided we're gonna have a photo in there, we're gonna need two buttons, so probably this one is the best. So what I did is I copied this, I created a new page, which I already did right here, as you can see, homepage, and I pasted this. I'm gonna show you real fast that it works, right? So I just did like that. And then we decided we're gonna wanna show some logos here. So again, you have a lot of options. You can go to logos, you can find the one you want. I think I use this one. You can go back to your page and just copy paste. So it's that easy. You can just copy paste element and build the whole structure for your home page and then send it for approval, right? Once your client approves the sections, then you can start writing the content. So in the second step, I'm gonna write the copy, right? I like to use ChatGPT to write the actual copy. So here is the actual chat. So I started by referring to Donald Miller because Donald Miller is a great copywriter and he has this established framework, which is called Story Brand Framework. So I started by asking if you can help me come up with a copy for my homepage according to this structured framework, right? So then what I did is I went to the existing website and just selected all, just like this, it doesn't matter, copied all of this and pasted here and said, hey, here is the current copy. So basically ChatGPT said, hey, provide me with the current copy and I will revise it for you according to this framework. So this is what I did. I copied the whole content and then I got some results. And then I started asking specific questions, right? For example, we need a short headline for the hero section and a paragraph underneath and a two calls to action, one primary, one secondary, right? Told GPT what I want. I'm gonna talk about the sections that I want and you're gonna write me the headlines and paragraphs, right? You see? Headline, unlock the potential of medicinal cannabis, paragraph, embark, blah, blah, blah. You can just follow up, make it shorter, and just tweak it until you're satisfied. And then the second section, your pathway to becoming certified medicinal cannabis expert. And I talk about, we're gonna have three boxes. So I'm talking about the section underneath here, like we have a headline here, and then we have three subheads and three paragraphs underneath. And we're gonna mention some benefits here. Basically, I used this copy almost like I revised this copy a little bit, but for the most part, it was great. You know, I've included some, I basically combined the existing copy in client requirements and made it better. Here, I also pasted like client provided me some information for the pricing tiers. I pasted that. I asked ChatGPT to make them shorter, which it did. In general, ChatGPT is awesome for writing copy, right? So that's the second step. So you basically build this wireframe with the dummy text. Then you write the actual content based on the client requirements. So you have all the copy in place and then you make client approve this. Now the next step is to want to add the content, right? So adding the content for this, I use Midjourney to generate some of the photos. So you can find stock photos, but I needed something specific. So as you can see, here is the prompt, a doctor with a laptop and a marijuana leaf prescribing cannabis, right? So this is something very kind of unusual. It could be hard to find this on stock photo websites. So it's a unique image, right? We just needed three close-up photos right here. And here is going to be an illustration that they provided me with. So basically, I'm just continuing beyond the copy with the photos, with the illustrations and so on. And now the next step is to create a style guide. Basically, I took the existing style guide, which I developed back in 2021, and then I created the styles for the headlines, for the body text. I transferred the colors, so I have everything there. So let me show you how it's done. You can start with the fonts, right? According to the style guide, which I have right here, you can start with the typography, we should use Atlas Bold and Manrup Regular. So here on an unstyled, this is how it looks when it's unstyled. You see, it uses just Roboto and just some like black and white colors. But once you start changing this, so once you have this selected, you're gonna see something like that. You're gonna see text style. So what you wanna do is you wanna click this icon and you wanna start changing the properties for each. Or you can just go and find this plugin, which is called Batch Styler. And if you run this plugin, you can basically tell it, hey, change everywhere that where it uses Roboto, right? So all of these changed to LoRa. We decided to use LoRa as an alternative to Atlas, right? And then you can update. And what it's gonna do is gonna update. This is not using the style, that's the only exception here. So we have to do it manually. But look, all of these will replace, and then you can do the same with the body text, and you can do the same with the colors, and the same with the buttons. And once you're done, you're gonna have something like that, right? So you see, I change even the color, the fonts, and I have the primary color palette and secondary color palette. And what it does basically, while you are changing, this is gonna update the styles automatically throughout all components, right? So as you can see, this has been like pre-styled for you basically, you know, like if you look at this, we have the colors here, we have the fonts here. But what's great is that when we go back to our home page, this is how you design the whole page. Then I've added a few things like this pattern in the background. I changed the background color, as you can see here, but I had already these color styles and the font styles, so it was super easy. So I built it basically in one day, the whole thing, right? And I tweaked a few things. I've added the photos and the whole website is done. Now if I need, I can just go and say I need career page, right? So I can just copy some of these sections which are already basically done, and I just need to like tweak them a little bit, add some graphics, add some other colors, add some patterns, of course change the text and stuff like that. But for the most part, it's built, and this is basically how you design the home page. So that's a quick overview of my structured web design process, and this is how I use Figma and other tools like Reloom library to deliver websites to my clients. Now if you want me to dive deeper and actually rebuild this home page live here on YouTube, then leave a comment below, because I have these files saved at each stage, so I can just share them with you and we can rebuild this website together just to practice. But anyways, consider subscribing to my channel for more tips on branding, strategy and design. This was Arek Dvornechuck from eBay Design, and I will see you in the next video.